Welcome in, Mr. Joel Houston from United.
That's exciting.
Good to have you here.
It's good to be here in person.
Yeah, isn't that nice? It's been a minute, right?
Mm-hmm. How long has it been?
Since we were in person.
Yeah.
I can't remember. Everything feels like it's a blur the entire last couple of years.
But right?
It's been a while, you know? So,
yeah.
You know, I've been listening. I'm hearing your voice every single day, but it's...
Well, it's good. I mean, that was a crazy... it's still going, but it's been a crazy year and a half-ish. I don't even know how long it's been.
Isn't it like it's really for us brought into focus how great and how important it is to have worship?
Oh, yeah. I mean, everything, all the small things that we often take for granted, you know, like just like being in person, community.
Yeah.
This week's been so fun seeing so many friends for the first time, even people you work with, you know, in the flesh. So.
Mm-hmm.
It feels like we're coming through it.
I've heard from multiple people, especially, you know, people that tour, it was great to be with family, you know, because you're on the road so much, you miss your family, but then you're like, well, maybe time to go back on the road.
Well, I mean, that's the balancing act you didn't expect. You know, you spend so much time, you get into a rhythm between being away, being home, and then you're just home for a long time.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I'm grateful for a very patient wife. Because suddenly, you know, we have to figure out all this stuff. So,
she's like, wait a minute, this is my territory. You're not normally here for this.
My son's getting sick of me, you know, because he normally gets access to the remote control, so he can do whatever he wants.
Oh.
Hey, no, son. You know, I'm sorry, I'm home today.
Did you pick up any new hobbies? A lot of people talk about hobbies over the last year and a half.
I did. I picked up a golf club for the first time.
And really?
I thought, listen, if I am going to play this game, if you can call it a game, some might call it torture. But I thought, you know what, I just want to be like good enough to not be embarrassed. So I kind of set my attention on that. Also, there's a few other things I got into, but that was the main one.
Yeah? How do you like golf? Are you any good at it?
Well, I'm just good enough. I'm not good enough to get mad about it.
You know,
that's helpful. So that was the first big life lesson I learned. You know, there's so many parallels, truthfully, to like the kingdom and the gospel. I know that sounds funny, but it was huge. I think there was actually a golf tournament the other day.
Yeah.
The GMA. And so we held our own, you know. I just want to be good enough to compete with Chris Tomlin and not be embarrassed.
So he's all right. He's decent.
Yep.
You know what? He looks like a golfer, come to think of it.
I just think Chris is one of those guys who's just kind of good at whatever he sets his attention to.
Does he do the whole golf, polo, khakis?
He does, and he pulls it off.
I could see that.
Am I right?
I could see that.
He looks like a golfer.
Yeah.
I do have to ask you a really weird question, and this is totally off topic. I discovered this thing about myself this morning. In talking to Michelle, she was sharing this food hack. Like, you ever heard of Five Guys Burgers?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There's a food hack on TikTok right now where you ask them for an extra bun, and they give you an extra bun for free. And then you take their regular burger, which comes with two patties, and you basically make two burgers. And I'm like, so why would I eat two burgers? It's just like a lot of extra bread.
And I was like, no. Like, you have one and I have one.
And it never even popped in my mind. She was talking about sharing a meal. I was thinking about eating two burgers. Is this a guy thing? Like, because seriously, I was like thinking back the last couple of weeks. I don't like when people grab food off my plate.
I hear you. You know, like one of my, I mean, firstly, you may have unlocked one of the great mysteries of relationships between men and women. That's amazing. But secondly, you know, I'll say to my wife, I'll like, listen, do you want this? And she's like, no, I'm fine. I don't want that. I'm like, are you sure? So I end up ordering more food anyway.
Yeah.
And sure enough, doesn't matter what she orders or what I order for her, she's going after what I've got on my plate.
It always looks better than our salad.
But then as soon as you see her hand coming over to grab something off your plate, something inside of me, like, I get a little sad. I don't know what it is. Like a little, like a R.I.P. French fry. I wanted that.
See, and I think women are the opposite, because I'm like, if I share it with him, it's like half the calories, half the food go. Like, I only want half the burrito.
I don't think like that.
I just don't want the whole thing.
You know, I think sometimes it's just, hey, if it looks good, eat it. Whatever. If it tastes good.
Just don't take anything off my plate. That's all I'm saying. I felt like that was the lesson I learned. Thank you for making me feel a little bit better, because we did share this on the air, and it was like, why were you thinking that you were eating two burgers? I'm like, of course I would. I ordered it.
Why would I add the bread?
So you mentioned Chris Tomlin. We got to talk about this, because you guys just announced something huge, and I don't want to, you know, spoil it. What's going on? What's happening with Chris Tomlin?
Well, we haven't, all our guys are in Australia. We haven't toured. It's been almost 3 years it will be by the time we get
to Wow.
Yeah, so we are pretty excited to announce our tour with Chris Tomlin, Hillsong United. Chris Tomlin, Tomlin United. So it's, for spring 2022. And so it's been something we've been working on for a long time, thinking about. Chris and I talked about it, honestly, for about 10 years.
Oh, wow.
And then we started planning it right before COVID hit. And then we've pushed it back. And here we are. It's going to happen.
So spring 2022, big tour, North American tour. What is it?
Yeah. I don't know how many dates there is, but there's a lot. We're all over the place. Yeah. So we're covering the whole country. I think it's like 40 dates or so.
What are you looking forward to most about getting back on tour?
Listen, I miss my friends, you know. So our guys in Australia, I haven't seen them since before lockdown. So they haven't been able to get here. And so I miss that. I mean, that's my favorite thing about tour is actually the relationships along the way. You know, we've been doing this for a long time, traveling almost 20 years. And so, you know, we're still friends at the end of the day and just love life. I love the moments, obviously, the nights and everything that God does, the stories that you hear, people who may never, you know, go to a church, or they might have turned their back on that, but they're willing to come to this experience and in the, you know, the presence of God, you can't, there's nothing competes with it, you know? And so what God does in that place, that's huge. Mm. But honestly, at the end of the day, I miss my friends, you know, being with them. And so, like, you know, the stories, the journey, you know, everybody's got families now, you know, done a lot of life. But I think that's where the hidden beauty and blessing is. And whatever it is we do, you know, sometimes we get wrapped up in these big moments and these big achievements. But at the end of the day, it's the journey along the way. I think when we look back at all of the story, and that's certainly been my story, when I look back, the fondness is in having heart-to-hearts in the middle of the night or walking through seasons with friends and coming out the other side and going, hey, we're still here, we're still going, and God's still good.
You know, you were talking about the experiences that people have going to the shows, going to the live shows. I think people are really looking forward to getting back and doing that. Is there a story that sticks out to you over your, you know, many years of touring and meeting different people that have been to your shows?
I mean, there's so many. You know, what's amazing is I think there's been certain nights, like nights that you look forward to, like it might be a venue or something that's always dreamed of.
Sure.
On those nights, the lasting memory always for me ends up being about like one person or somebody who you spot like in the crowd and you watch the journey. It's almost like, I don't know this person's story. I don't know what this person's going through, how they came to be here. But I find myself kind of locking in on somebody and just seeing how over the course of the night, it's almost like something gets unlocked in that person. Mm. I remember, there's a moment on our last tour, and we're at Staples Center in LA, so it's, you know, it's huge, but we go from this stage that's in the center to the stage that's the main stage. And I was walking along and I saw this guy, this kid actually who was on his phone, and so I kind of just joked with the kid. I said, oh, what game are you playing? Yeah. This is in the middle of worship, everybody's singing.
Yeah.
And I walked on, then we sung the bit in the middle, and as I was coming back about 10-15 minutes later, I saw the same kid, and next to him was a gentleman. He grabbed me, and he looked at me, and he just said, hey, you need to understand. And he basically told me that a couple of weeks earlier, his wife and his daughter and I think another kid had tragically been killed in an accident, that they were meant to be there that night. And he went on to kind of say, like, you know, I wasn't going to be here. I was ready to give up on God and the whole thing. And he just was like thanking me for what God was doing in that moment. Mm. And I just forgot about what was happening. And we sat there and just had a cry and hug. And I just realized, like, this is just one person in this room of all these different people going through this awful circumstance. But like, you just don't know what God's doing in that room. And I think that's why we're passionate about doing it all these years, because we get to just kind of create an opportunity for people to gather together. And there's power in community, there's power in collective worship. Mm-hmm. But it's the stories of the people, as mundane as they may be, or as tragic as they may be, or as incredible as they may be across that room. That's what the church looks like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And there's an opportunity for God in that space to do, I think, things that that we pray for day in, day out. You know,
absolutely.
God
just
shows up. As I'm just, when you're talking, I see it. I see it visually, what you're just talking about. It's so neat. I think about the body of Christ and how we use our gifts, you know, to glorify him. You know, you're doing your thing and we get on the air and we're trying, we got camera guys in here and they're doing their thing, glorifying God with your gifts that you're given. And like, but every once in a while, like something will stop you in your tracks to show you God's love, God's here. He's working through you. You have a purpose, you know, because there's just times where you've seen it, where people just feel like, I have no purpose. I'm just at the end of my ropes, and you're seeing it firsthand. And that's just, it's just an amazing thing, but also an amazing reminder from God. Those are the ones you really appreciate, I would imagine.
Yeah. I mean, I think sometimes we overcomplicate things and we get caught up in these things that really maybe don't matter at the end of the day. Yeah. Like God, like even as in our humanity as people, like there's so many, we share so many experiences, so many feelings. Like, you know, mm-hmm. we think sometimes I'm the only person feeling this or that.
Right.
But actually, you know, there's so much that we share and there's so much, all of those things, God is absolutely perfect sweeping in and being the only one who can meet that need or that or mm-hmm. whatever that is. And I think that shared sense of need, simple, hey, I've got doubts, I've got questions, I don't have the answers, I don't know how we're going to get through this season, I don't know how we're going to manage that. I think that feeling of I'm alone in this, I'm the only one, it looks like everyone else has got it sorted out, mm-hmm. and I can't figure out how to tie my shoes in the morning, you know, like,
right.
And God is at the same time going, no, that's all I want mm-hmm. from you. Like, is in just a dependence on him.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where God is so good at meeting us, you know, along the way. And that's not something that you figure out on last Tuesday and then you've got it sorted for the rest of your life.
Right, 100%.
It's not something you discover, you know, maybe you discover it for the first time or in a new way, in a worship experience, mm-hmm. you know. But at the end of the day, that's something that we continue to journey day in, day out. Next Tuesday, I'm going to need God's grace in a new way, mm-hmm. but in the same way as I always have. And that's the journey of faith. It's not like, I've figured this faith thing out now. Like, mm-hmm. no, it's always one step mm-hmm. in front of the other, one day after the other. And I love that, you know, his mercies are new every single morning.
Mm-hmm.
What does that say? It says we need them every single day, you know. And so I think as simple as that is, I don't know that it has to be any more complex in our journey, yeah. you know. And that's, I think that's helpful, at least for someone like me.
Absolutely. I mean, for all of us. I want to ask you, one of my favorite things, you know, working here at Air One, all getting to hear and experience all of this music on a daily basis, and your latest single, Know You Will, has impacted so many people. I mean, we hear from people. One of my favorite things is to hear the story behind the music. Like, tell me about what led you to write this. Can you share that?
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting because, so during the lockdown period, you know, we've been working on music the whole time. It's been difficult for us because we normally do that together.
But sure.
The guys have been in Australia. And, I was actually working on my golf swing one night. I know this sounds funny, but inside the studio, and I was trying to shallow my, for anyone who knows, you're meant to go from the inside out, which is interesting.
Yeah.
So I was trying to figure this out, and I came under the ball. The ball shot up into the roof, hit the fire sprinkler.
No.
You know, oh, no.
Exploded.
Oh,
the
no.
Next thing you know, the entire studio was flooded.
What?
And wow.
Yeah, I didn't know what to do. So I ran around. I called Dylan, who, you know, is one of our guys. He plays guitar. And I said, Dylan, what do we do? He's like, I'll call the fire department. Anyway, fire department came. Dylan and I are there sweeping water out of the studio. And then, you know, we had to wait for ServPro to come and figure out how to fix it. We had a couple of hours to go. I said, well, listen, if we're here, man, like, we might as well try and write, you know. And so Dylan went in, started playing the piano. And next thing you know, I was just singing that chorus over the top of it. And then the lyric kind of just formed itself. I don't know how you make a way, but I know you will. It's funny now because there's all those other metaphors, you know, where I see a flood, you see a promise, you know. But that's yeah. that's not what the song was about, really. I think it really encapsulated so much of what was in our heart for the church.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
And the season that we're in. And, you know, I love what it says in that second verse and just saying, hey, like, sometimes we look around at the world around and about us and everybody's freaking out. And, like, I'm thinking, hey, like, God's not, none of this surprises God.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the worst news, that's not a surprise to God. He's just not finished yet. You know, like, when the world stops or it feels like everything's on fire, like, he doesn't flinch at bad news. He's like, and he's not going to leave us high and dry in that. You know, he wants to journey us to deepen our faith, deepen our trust in him, deepen our resolve in his promise. And again, I think that was, for me, that was this kind of like, just really helpful kind of realignment tool during the whole season, no matter what was going on in the world, no matter what was going on in personally or in friends. It was like, hey, like, it's not like, this is any surprise to God, and mm-hmm. he is who he says he is. He's going to do what he says he's done. When you read the Bible, it's just full of stories, repetitive, where God showed up, where we couldn't figure it out on our own, you know, mm-hmm. and yet God is good enough to journey that through with us because he wants to partner with us in what he's ultimately establishing. And I think that gives me great hope for the church. It gives me great hope for what God's doing in America and around the world.
Yeah.
It gives me great hope for my family and for yours and for everybody else. And so it was the first song we kind of wrapped up and finished during that season, and it just felt right. And a pointer towards where we're heading, hopefully.
So powerful.
We heard that for the first time. We're like, this has to be heard now. It's just that's one awesome. Of those songs where it just kind of, worship has been like that the last year and a half. Have you noticed that? Like, the lyrics are deeper. We've grown a little more raw.
I love it. Yeah. You know, I'm absolutely, you know, and I can't say I've always felt this way, but I really feel like there's, you know, there's been this renaissance of sorts, especially out of the songs. With a deep desire to connect with the church and be sung together. I think the songs feel like they're carrying real, you know, like flesh and blood, you know, like real life.
Yeah.
And I think sometimes we forget, you know, we can think about God and we think about the spirit side of it, but we got to remember that, you know, Jesus, he was human as well. You know, he went through all of these things for us. You know, he had the doubts. He had the questions. This is, you know, God, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So that's to me, being able to relate to that Savior, you know, who had all of God in him, was all spirit, and yet was able to kind of walk that out in a real flesh and blood way. To me, that's the best way that we can communicate the gospel to the world. Because otherwise it just becomes this fairy thing that's, you know, pie in the sky type stuff. And it's like, no, this is a personal God. This is a God who can, like, relate with our sorrows and who carried them, who went through them. And so I hear that in the songs because I believe that the songs are coming from a place of real experience, you know, people who are asking real questions and wanting to dig deeper into who God is and give confession to that, that is faith building. And so I'm super excited about, I mean, so many incredible artists, you guys are playing all their songs, but I just think it's a new day. And I think, you know, as the church begins to come back together and whatever the future holds, I think there's always been a song for the move of God. There always has been a song that kind of in some ways precedes what God does and also goes along with it. And so all the greats that we love from yesteryear, you know, I believe that there's songs being written right now that are going to carry us into for decades to come.
Was there a particular song that helped you kind of get through everything that was going on during the pandemic? And
I mean, there's a ton. I think I love actually Jaira for me, just like as simple as obviously it's not just me, but you know, what that song kind of just as simple as it is encapsulated, I think is was real. And there's so many others. But I also, you know, I went back to like the first songs that I loved, you know, worship music. So like old Delirious music and
whoa,
these songs that kind of, you know, were super formative in kind of trying to figure out God when I was a teenager. Or
whatnot.
And, I found that stuff really nice. And then for me also, my escape, like that's writing songs. You know, I kind of tried to at least write something every single day. And it's a form of devotion, you know, like that didn't matter what was going on, but to just sit at the piano and at least just kind of just let it flow. And so there's all these unfinished songs. There's all this unfinished music. And that's okay. It's, for me, it's not even about finishing them or wrapping them up and having them, you know, the world's thing. I think there's something about the process of just exploring God through the mystery of music, and that I think it's just has been really helpful. So that's been fun. You know, I'm excited about what might come from that too.
Well, that's good, right? We appreciate you so much.
So.
Seriously,
yeah,
for coming in. What a great conversation. Just flew by.
Yeah.
Too.
Did you ever fix the golf swing that you were working on the night?
I don't know that you ever fixed the golf swing. I try to every single day. You know?
Can I fix my swing? Swing of the miss. Can I fix that?
Yeah. Well, yeah, the studio got fixed. It's all sorted.
Well, you're tall. How tall are you?
6'5".
Okay, so I'm 6'3", and I feel like it's because I was tall, I can't hit the ball.
Yeah, so
but
it's
you,
a long way.
You
long
changed
way.
That.
The ball's a lot further away for me than most people. Yeah.
Right. But you fixed that. You figured out a way to do it.
Yeah, exactly.
Lean over.
Super excited though for you guys to get back on tour, to get out there, for people to go have that worship experience with you guys, with Hillsong United, with Chris Tomlin, and that kicks off February 9th. through April 13th. So check the website for dates and a city near you.
TomlinUnited.com.
See, he knows. I didn't have
Joel
that.
Joel Houston. Thank you so much, man.
Thank you for taking the time.
God bless you, brother.